Of course, the collapse in Baltimore of all too familiar for folks in Minnesota. It's been almost 17 years since the 35W bridge collapsed over the Mississippi River. Tonight, the new 35W bridge is lit up in the colors of the Maryland state flag to show support for the city of Baltimore and all involved in today's tragedy. In the hours after today's collapse, leaders who helped Minnesota navigate the collapse here offered their expertise to Maryland.
Ian Russell has what they're saying, along with thoughts from a local expert tonight.
As an engineer, there are things you plan for.
As to what the performance should be under various events.
And things you never expect.
It's essentially a freak accident.
An early Tuesday morning.
213 dispatch, the whole bridge just fell down. The whole bridge just collapsed.
This freak accident led to the collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore.
And when something happens like this, it puts a little pit in your stomach.
Travis Welt is the chair of civil engineering at the University of St. Thomas. As the sun rose, a clearer picture of what happened and a clearer picture for engineers like Welt.
This is something that we understand is possible, but almost, you think about it as infinitesimally small chance of happening. But obviously in this case, it did happen.
For many in the metro, it's a familiar sight.
We want to take you live to Minneapolis now, where there has been a bridge collapse of 35W Bridge.
That initial shock can be scary as an engineer.
It's also scary for the ones who were there through it all.
And I think like so many people who were involved, the memories came flooding in.
Former Minneapolis Mayor R.T. Ryback also connecting Baltimore to Minneapolis.
I carry a fair amount of that with me to this day.
But Welt is quick to point out, while our cities are connected by a tragedy like this, the reasons behind them are different. It's why he's emphasizing we wait until we fully know what happened.
Wait until the experts have weighed in and provided their analysis and their input as to what happened. And then think about, how do we move forward from that, right? How do we think about how we design things moving forward?
I asked Welt about that video where you can see the entire bridge collapse. I wanted to know if there was a reason why it would completely collapse, not just what the boat hit. He reiterated that without hearing from experts on the ground in Baltimore, it's hard to say exactly what happened.